Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me on Skype is Randall Crowder from Phunware. Randall, great to see you as always.
Great to see you, Christine. Thanks for having me again. You're never going to get rid of me.
Randall, this week Phunware launched an initial exchange offering of its Phun token on Liquid Global. For investors who aren't familiar with what this means, what is an initial exchange offering?
Absolutely. It's interesting. You know, so you fast, you know, rewind back to 2017, you had initial coin offerings, ICOs. We all realized that 90% of those were total scams or frauds or entrepreneurs trying to pretend like they were entrepreneurs. And then they realized, wow, you know, running a business is really hard. And they all, you know, left or abandoned their projects. What happened, though, is we realized the need for an ecosystem in order to drive crypto and blockchain forward. And so part of that ecosystem, really, you know, the center of gravity right now are the exchanges. You know, that's where people go to trade crypto. That's where people go often for their news. And it's actually where they go for kind of credibility. You know, so whether it's a Binance or a Wobi or a Liquid, these exchanges have become the center of gravity for everybody looking at what's next, what's the next project. And so what they're doing now is doing a lot of the due diligence that unfortunately a lot of people didn't do in 2017. And they're seeing, is this a real company? Is there a real use case for this blockchain? What's the, you know, they actually require a legal opinion of, you know, really, is this a security? Is it a utility? They require an audit of the actual blockchain protocol. So they're functioning almost like a venture capitalist or a private investor would, collecting all that due diligence on a project, verifying it, kind of validating it, giving it their seal of approval, and then releasing it to their member base. And they do it in a very short window of time. So that we've announced an initial exchange offering launch date. So it'll be at the end of the month, and it'll only be open for a couple days, and purchasers will be able to buy an allocation of Phun tokens in that short window of time. They'll also be able to receive a bonus structure. So based on their purchase, they'll get additional tokens. They'll also have a referral bonus based on people they bring in during that campaign. They'll get some additional tokens for that. So it's really a great event to distribute a lot of your tokens to a member base tied to an exchange in a window of time without this protracted long sales cycle of the ICOs where you're just constantly trying to do one-off sales. And so, you know, the exchanges have done a great job of curating where are the best projects, where are the best deals. We stand behind this deal. We're going to release it to our members and everybody kind of wins. So that's what's been in vogue lately. And I think that's what we're really excited to launch Phun Token on Liquid. Reputable exchange, access to key markets for us in Asia, Indonesia, India, South Korea, Japan, you know, Singapore. These are areas where we really see a proliferation of crypto use cases in the real world. You know, they're light years ahead of where the US is. And so by launching Phun on these exchanges, we get access to incredible markets for our project. And we also get to raise, you know, some additional capital for Phunware.
Well, just remind us a bit about Phun. This is a utility token, so just kind of talk me through it.
Yeah, so unfortunately, due to the regulatory climate, we're not selling in the U.S., Canada, and obviously no sanctioned countries right now. But, you know, outside of that, really what Phun is about is we all know social media. We all live these digital lives. We're always engaging with different platforms. Every time you engage with a brand, someone is making money. Every time you swipe something, click something, respond to something, forward something, it's all being aggregated in the virtual world by these large data companies. And they're all making a lot of money on it. You know, The Economist was really famous a couple years ago for saying that data had surpassed oil as the most valuable asset on the planet. And I think we all kind of, you know, we understand why. I mean, data underpins everything. So our thesis with Phun is if you're the source of that data, just like if you were a landowner with oil on your land, you would have to pay that landowner, wouldn't you? Well, right now, you have companies like Facebook and Google that have set up, you know, drills and rigs all over the world, and they're not paying any landowners. We're thinking, well, that doesn't make sense. So why don't we set up a system that allows brands to engage with consumers on a one-to-one basis using all the information we know about that consumer, that they know we know about them, that they're willing to share because they want that engagement to be meaningful to them. And every time they engage with that brand, rather than paying a data oligarch like a Facebook or a Google, we'll actually pay the consumer. It's their data, it's their engagement. So with Phun Token, we can unlock all the features and capabilities of Phunware's platform, our fully integrated cloud platform for mobile that drives engagement that we've built over the last 10 years, has all these amazing features that brands can use to engage consumers. Every time they do it, let's say they watch a rewarded video, they respond to a survey, they go to a location in the real world to respond to a marketing campaign, we'll actually pay the consumers for doing that because that's going to drive profitable behavior for those brands. So Phun Token will underpin all of that. It's really, you know, valuing your engagement with brands.
You mentioned the offering will be in a month's time. How exactly can investors participate?
Yeah, so you actually want to be, you got to be a member of Liquid. Liquid, again, is an incredible exchange. We announced this in July, or kind of earlier this summer, that we would be looking at initial exchange offerings. So we've been talking to a lot of the exchanges. Couldn't be more impressed with the entire team over at Liquid. Their due diligence into us, their partnership, you know, they're doing things the right way. They are absolutely a credible exchange, very well known in the industry. One of the few that are actually, you know, regulated and have the right approvals in Japan, actually, which is no small feat. And so you want to, you know, go to liquid.com, easy enough, you know, sign up, be a member. And then whenever the announcement comes out that you can buy, and it'll be at the end of this month, at the end of September, first week of October, that IEO window will be open to Liquid members, but the allocation is limited, so you want to get in as early as possible so that, you know, if it does run out for what we're, you know, putting out on Liquid, you at least had a chance to participate.
Well, you were just here in New York presenting at an investor conference. What are investors and potential investors saying about the Phunware story?
Yeah, you know, I think, you know, for us, it's, you know, you think of like the Amazons of the world or the Microsofts of the world, when you go to those, you know, websites, it's like, wow, what do they not do? And so because we're a fully integrated cloud platform for mobile, we do so much, it's kind of a catch-22. You know, you do a lot, so you add a lot of value, you can build a lot of value, and you can build a big company, which is what we're all here to do, that actually makes a meaningful difference. But it makes that 30-second elevator pitch a little hard. And so part of these conferences is about explaining it to the investor community, specifically institutional investors, a lot of funds who are interested in small cap stocks, what our story is, what we do, how we got to this place. And so we made that available recently. I have a video recap that's a little over 10 minutes, so it's not too bad, but I definitely encourage everyone to watch it. One of the things that ties this back to the IEO that is important to understand, though, is we've been around for 10 years. We've raised $100 million. We went public last December, but we haven't raised money since we filed to go public. So that was, you know, almost 2 years ago. We have already told people in our Q2 earnings audio cast that we are not going to issue additional equity, which will be dilutive to shareholders at the current stock price. And so for us, what does that mean? It's actually, you know, I spent 10 years as a venture capitalist. It's exactly what I want entrepreneurs to tell me. We are running our business by signing up new business. The only other two interesting items that we would consider in terms of financing growth beyond just what we're doing organically, responsibly, is debt financing, which, you know, it's always a consideration. And actually this IEO mechanism that we just talked about. Think about what that is with an IEO. You're literally generating non-dilutive financing. It's, you know, basically selling digital products at 100% gross margin. So I'll take that all day long. So I hope people understand that all of this is really, you know, helping us move the ball forward in a responsible manner, really, you know, grow Phunware by selling products, because that's what we are. We're an enterprise software company. We're a SaaS company. And we're signing up new business, and we're working with exchanges to launch, you know, our token, which will underpin an entire industry paradigm shift for us. So we're excited about reimagining how brands engage consumers. And along the way, you know, we think it'll be a pretty profitable endeavor.
Randall, great to catch up. Hope to see you next time you're in New York. Thanks so much.
Absolutely. Can't wait.